I'd be lost in a crowded room of fake friends. I wouldn't even know what love is if we never met. What if I never started singing? What if you never told your family you were leaving when you felt the pressure? There's a million different reasons we shouldn't be together, but when I put it all together, it all comes back to you, you, you. I love it when the only light is me, you, and the moon. And baby, when I close my eyes, I'm thinking about if we never met.
The Tenors.
We acknowledge that the land on which we are gathered is part of the traditional territory of the Chippewa, Odawa, Potawatomi, and Delaware Nations.
Greetings to all graduates, families of Queen Elizabeth, and staff. I won't be the first or the last to say these are extraordinary times that we are currently in. Let's shift our thinking in that this is an extraordinary time to be finishing an elementary school career. Each and every one of you are knights, some for 10 years, others for one. Yet your presence, your actions, has shaped and impacted the way you are and the school you are currently leaving. You've all made Queenie a better place in some way. This year will be filled with uniquely cherishable memories that you will carry with you forever. Opportunities to meet online with your teachers and EA and friends, chances to become proficient in the use of online learning tools, and most importantly, time management through independence. This is the shift I want you to focus on, the skills that you will have explored, bettered, and honed over the last few months. Integrate this understanding with the other brilliant memories of your time as a knight. Sometimes I wonder if what makes something a memorable moment is not what we take from it, but what we put into it. These are the things we can control: our kindness, our gratitude, our inclusion. You should celebrate these moments that you've shown those traits. And they're also represented in our Go Knights acronym. This additionally includes traits of optimism, need for knowledge, grit, honor, teamwork, and support. Something we will be celebrating in each of you as a special recognition today. Each of you can identify a moment where you identified and exemplified one of these traits and made the day of someone around you richer, better, just through your actions. These actions proliferate and serve to form our school culture. Now, perhaps you are thinking, I could have done more. This is the journey of self-improvement, being able to identify ways to get better, controlling our behavior as this turns into actions that improve the lives of those around us. This is friendship. This is love. Maybe you leave here wishing you had done more. Make today that day. Make this moment that moment where you commit to do better for those around you and ultimately yourself. What will that look like as you head to high school? Only you can decide this. I encourage you to show gratitude to all those who have helped you to get to this point in your life, including friends and family. They deserve it. Please know the gratitude the staff and I feel for each of you and the indelible mark you leave on Queen Elizabeth. In times of uncertainty, you can be a beacon of hope and optimism by celebrating those around you and making these extraordinary times and days. This shift is yours to make. Good luck, graduates.
Your life. The Betsy Steele Memorial Award is presented to a student who's been an example of the dedication that Mrs. Steele brought to our school family. The student sets high standards and goals and is willing to put in the tough, hard work to get there. Above all, the student has consistently lived up to academic, school, and extracurricular responsibilities and has done so with a positive attitude and no need for fanfare. That last bit of no need for fanfare was exactly who Mrs. Steele was. She saw something that had to be done and she just went about doing it, and she made it seem like fun so other people wanted to help. Our Betsy Steele Memorial Award winner for this year is that kind of person. Ashley Wood doesn't need recognition. She doesn't need anybody to celebrate what she's doing behind the scenes. She just goes about it every day, including making sure that all of our Chromebooks and all of our iPads are charged so that everybody else had something to work with the next day. I'm very pleased to give this award to Ashley.
Hello, graduates and families. I'm Mr. Spencer, the resource teacher for grades 4 through 8. This is my first year being directly part of the graduation, and I'm honored to be able to share with you the winner of the LRC Improvement Medal. This is presented to the graduating student who has received Learning Resource Center support and who has shown outstanding and consistent improvement in academic achievement and effort. The recipient of this medal goes to a very well-deserving student. Thinking about all that we've gone through this school year, one student stood out to me with her resilience, dedication, and effort. When we were in school, she always accepted assistance, tried her best, and asked questions if she was unsure of something, which can be very challenging for some. Once we put an iPad in her hands for writing, there was no stopping her from completing the tasks that she needed to get done. When it came to working with me on math, she paid attention, listened, and attempted tasks no matter how challenging they may have been. Tanasia Brown has made significant improvement in her effort, academic achievement throughout the school year. I wish her all the luck in grade 9 at JMSS. Congratulations to you. Well done, and you deserve it.
The Murray French Award is presented to the graduating student that has shown consistent and outstanding improvement in academic effort. This student that is receiving this award constantly seeks out ways to improve and is looking forward to high school. Tanner Primo, you have a bright future ahead of you. Congratulations.
Good evening, graduates. We're here to present this Mr. Barr and Mr. Van Kessel. We're here to present the Athletic Award this year. Very unusual times, as we all know. So this year, we're going to present the award based on the years of athletic abilities here at Queen E School. We're going to base them on the three main criteria of the award.
The first thing we look for as a student athlete, obviously, is athletic skill.
99, 100, 101.
The second trait we look for is sportsmanship.
Come on, Mr. Barr, one more. You can do it. You can do it, Mr. Barr. One more. Attaboy. Mr. Barr.
The last quality we look for is leadership.
2, 1.
That's okay, Mr. Van Kessel. We'll get him next time.
So after that wonderful video that you just viewed, it's time to announce our two winners. The male athlete of the years at Queen E School is Julian Haddock.
And the female athlete recipient is Trinity Walker.
The Ontario Principals Council Leadership Award is presented to the graduating student who has demonstrated reliability, honesty, trustworthiness, fairness, respect, and accountability. The student has been an active participant in the school and community, has been academically sound, has demonstrated leadership capabilities, and has also been involved in co-curricular activities. Above all, the student has acted in a responsible, independent manner and is an overall exemplary citizen of Queen Elizabeth II Public School. This year's recipient has been everything in this description in his time here at Queenie, showing kindness, acceptance, hard work, a sense of humor, and a sense of hair. The student has been involved in our Go Knights committee, was a regular morning announcer, and always found himself in a position to be helping others. He is very much himself and acts a model for what it means to be comfortable with one's own self. We are so pleased to have him as a knight, even if for a short time. I enjoyed working with the student as he demonstrated responsibility and pushed for a better Queen Elizabeth. We wish him all the best, knowing we are destined to see him on stage in theatrical productions in the future. Thank you, and congratulations to Spencer Simpson.
My name is Tim Regan, and I'm the chair of the Queen Elizabeth Parent Council. The Parent Council Award is presented to a graduating student who has demonstrated the values of perseverance and inclusion. This year's winner was described as always being themselves. They remained positive in all situations and looked for the best in people. They also accepted others for who they are, which is an admirable trait. This year's Parent Council Award winner is Chloe Horniman. Congratulations.
The Bev Eklund Graduate of the Year is presented to a graduated student who has achieved academic excellence and contributed to the school by acting as a student committee member, a house league participant, a school team member, and as an aide to the teachers and the staff on special projects. This student has demonstrated a sense of leadership, responsibility, and maturity both in and out of the classroom setting. During our homeschooling, I put up a writing activity about write about the person that you want to become. Now, not very many students did an amazing job on this, but one student took it to heart. What she wrote was touching. Mariah, this will lead you down the path of what type of person you want to become. The graduate of the year is Mariah Clough.
A few years ago, Queenie decided that we needed to start taking stock of our character traits that our young knights demonstrated. So we asked the school to come up with those character traits that they thought best represented our students and our staff. And from kindergarten through grade 8, these are the top character traits that our school decided we demonstrate as knights. Gratitude, optimism, kindness, need for knowledge, inclusion, grit, honor, teamwork, and support. And when you put those all together, you get Go Knights. We've been really fortunate at Queenie to have a strong community and lots of kids who show those really great characteristics every single day. Our grade 8s have a school career as knights, and they're going to take these traits with them not only just into high school, but into their post-secondary lives, into the workplace, into school, into apprenticeships, whatever pathway they choose, these traits are going to carry them places. We wanted to honor each graduate this year by saying the salient or most positive trait that they demonstrated in their school career. So without further ado, let's give our Go Knights Awards.
Gratitude comes from the Latin word gratis, meaning thankful or pleasing. It is a feeling of appreciation for a kindness that someone has done for you, and a willingness to be kind in return. It could be a nice word, a thoughtful gesture, or simply saying thank you. A very big thank you to our gratitude recipients, Cadence Cronmore and Cameron Dykeman.
Optimism means to be hopeful and confident in the future. An optimistic person looks forward to things. They're happy, they make others feel good being around them. They realize that it doesn't mean everything works out no matter what. Optimistic people know it's worth working hard because they know it pays off in the end and that their attitude can change their future. The award winners for optimism are Parker Gahula, Brian Whitewood, Darius Williams, and Tanisha Brown.
Kindness means being friendly and considerate to the people around you, and looking for ways to help others in big and small ways. It means reaching out to others with a smile, a deed, or a compliment to brighten their day. Congratulations to Ellie Isaac and Ashley Wood for consistently showing kindness.
The need for knowledge means that you stay curious and stay engaged in learning situations. You want to learn all you can about whatever it is that's going on. The need for knowledge has people engaged in their surroundings, which leads to them being observant. These students realize it's okay not to know, but it's not okay not to try to understand. The need for knowledge medals go to Mariah Clough, Julian Haddock, Spencer Simpson, and Saha Ahmad.
Inclusion means including everyone regardless of their differences. It means celebrating uniqueness and understanding that we all have different talents and experiences. Inclusive people make others feel accepted for just being themselves. Congratulations to Max Banks Kofel, Chloe Horniman, and Chantel Locke Kelly.
Grit means having inner mental strength. Grit gives you courage when experience challenge. It gives you the determination to keep going even when the going gets hard. It means thinking for yourself and not letting anyone tell you that you can't do it. The recipients of the Grit Award are Alexis Bayless, Jacob Dixon, Dakota McCray, Caden Cole, and Zakayla Simmons. Congratulations.
H is for honor. Honor means being reliable and consistent. If you say you will do something, you do it. You keep your promises. Honor means having a high standard for your own behavior. When you say things, they are believed to be true, and you have a reputation as a very honest person. Being honorable means you are a genuine person who makes choices based on what they believe. The honor medal goes to Trinity Walker.
Good afternoon, graduates. I'm here today to present the Teamwork Awards. Teamwork means that you are working with a group of peers to accomplish a goal. Sometimes that means that you take a leadership role, directing and helping other group members achieve their potential. Other times that means you have to kind of take a back seat and perhaps be a researcher, a data collector, or writer. In all cases, though, all group members to achieve that goal work and contribute to the main goal. So, congratulations go out to the following people for the Teamwork Award: Tierra Blackbird, Hannah Dewey, Landon LeMay, Alexis Newt, Kaylin Young, Xavier Heathcote. Congratulations, graduates.
I am pleased to be sharing the Support Award. Support means to help others by showing them how to do things when they are unsure, by being a good listener when someone needs to share their story, and by looking out for others, by showing that you care. Congratulations to Tanner Primo and Hayden Parker.
Good afternoon. I know graduation this year is different, but here's to making the best of it. I'd first like to thank all my amazing teachers for helping me succeed. I'd also like to thank my friends for helping me succeed. Because let's be honest, I wouldn't be here doing this if I'd never met you. I first came to this school scared, thinking that it'd be another school that I didn't really like. I came here in grade 3 from Dresden. I met some wonderful people like Miss Cranenberg, Miss C, Mr. Coatsworth, Mariah Chloe, Kane Scormore, and many more of the people graduating today. I'd like to thank all of you for our memories, especially some special girls that made me have the courage to talk to the board office with them. You know who all of you are. One memory I won't let go of is going to ropes with you guys. There's a lot of memories there. Just think about it. Another memory to hold on to are the staff-student games. This year has been a lot for everyone, and I feel amazing about ending our school year with all your faces. You guys are like family and will forever be in my mind and heart. I thank Ms. Smith, Ms. C, Mr. C for supporting all of us. Also, thank you, Mr. Allward, for making this school remain a great place. Another thank you goes out to Miss Maneri for being the best volleyball coach, Mr. Barr for being an excellent French teacher that makes a lot of dad jokes, and for being a good soccer coach, Mr. Van Kessel for being the meanest gym teacher ever. Just kidding, for being an amazing gym teacher and being hilarious, maybe just a bit of a bully. I'd like to thank Miss Pickering for being a nice vice principal and for telling me my brother shoved an airhead up his nose. That's a great memory. This year sure was like a roller coaster, but we all sat down, buckled up, and enjoyed the ride. It's still not over, so who knows, but right now is enough. So don't look down, look forward, and on into our very next destination. Having a great night, making the best of our summer, going into high school, and remembering this very night for ourselves, because it's still just as special. I hope you all enjoyed my speech. Thank you.
I want to congratulate all of our graduates who have persevered through these unprecedented times. Each and every one of you have amazing futures ahead of you. We want to thank everyone for your patience and understanding when faced with a pre-recorded graduation, definitely not the way we had hoped to celebrate with all of you, but necessary in this current situation. Once again, we thank you all for joining us today to celebrate our phenomenal graduates. We hope you have an amazing summer and look forward to an exciting year at the high school of your choosing.
Hey grade 8s, I just want to say congratulations. I'm so very proud of each and every one of you. You deserve all the success.
Congratulations, graduates of 2020. It's hard to believe the end of the school year is here and we're sending you off on a brand new adventure come September. Reflecting back at the whirlwind of a year we have had and thinking about all the hardships you've had to endure, one word comes to mind, and that is the word resilience. Resilience is defined as a capacity to recover quickly from difficulties. This seems like such a fitting word this year because of what all of you have had to go through and what you're going to have to go through in the future. Resilience is something that you learn. It comes from experiences and it comes from hardships. It isn't something that you're born with. This year has given you the opportunity to practice resilience. This year has prepared you for what's to come in life. Life throws you all kinds of twists and turns, but you are now better prepared for what life is going to throw at you. Resilience will get you through the first day of high school, your first set of exams, trying out for sports teams, getting up on stage for dramatic performance, or whatever you decide to do in high school. You have to fight through those hard times. A motivational speaker named Jeffrey Gittemier spoke these words: resilience is not what happens to you. It's how you react, respond, and recover from them. As a final word of advice, whatever path you take in life, whatever hardships you deal with, be the nice kid. This, tied with resilience, will take you great places. Congratulations to you all.
They say the journey of 1,000 miles begins with one small step. Well, you've completed your first step, graduates. Congratulations. At Queen E, we're very proud that we played a very small part in it, and we wish you all the best of luck as you continue your journey.
Hi, Grade 8s. Congratulations on making it through this crazy year. I, too, was disappointed when I heard there wasn't going to be a grad dance as I've been working on my moves through my maternity leave. Congratulations to our graduating class of 2020.
Hello, graduates. This is just a message from Mr. Jim, the guy that makes you work hard all year long in the gym, hopefully, and have some fun. This is just a special message of congratulations. I know it's been a really weird, unusual year, but think of the fact that you've made it through, not just this year, but the many years you've been at Queen E. And know that all the staff, including myself, are very proud of your efforts, what you've achieved, especially for me, on the court, off the court, and intramurals. I just wish the best for you next year and the years to come. And remember, stay healthy, stay fit. Take care.
Hello, graduates. I'm so proud of you. Miss Kaser here. I had some of you in my class. Feels like 5 minutes ago, but I know it's been a long time. I just wanted to say I'm so proud of you. Congratulations, and my advice is to believe in yourself.
Congratulations, class of 2020. You did it. This is a major accomplishment in your life, and I hope that you are truly proud of yourselves. Make sure to take time to recognize this truly remarkable and very special accomplishment. Enjoy your summer. And have a wonderful year next year in high school.
Congratulations, graduates of 2020. I'm pretty sure I taught most of you probably in grade 3, so I'm pretty aware of your true greatness. So here, myself and my daughter, Miss McPhail, we've got a poem for you. It's called True Greatness. The cap, the gown, the robe, the crown, the titles of today,
like mist before the morning sun,
will surely pass away.
Conceal your learning while you may,
nor list to emulation. Let others seek the road to fame,
strive not for reputation.
The hill is long and hard to climb, that leads you to success.
True greatness, after all, is just
a test of usefulness. Congratulations, and all the best in high school.
Well, congratulations to the 29 of you that graduated from Queen Elizabeth this year. Miss C and I right now, we're in the library recording this in front of our green screen. We were just down in the classroom, probably for the last time for a little while. And yes, it's a little bit of a sad day around here right now, but as we're watching this a little bit later on Monday, congratulations to everyone. It's a very, very weird experience planning this as our graduation, but going forward, I know each and every single one of you will do amazing things when you're at John McGregor or CK or a couple that are going to the Pines potentially in the fall. Big things are expected from each and every one of you. And again, I hope that we see you guys soon. Take care and have a great summer. Congratulations.
Dear graduates, I really wish we were planning this whole ceremony together, watching you guys practice going across the stage, deciding whether or not I'm gonna hug you when you go across. Is that okay or not okay? Wrapping up the year together in the mad, crazy chaos of a normal time. We didn't get that. We got ripped off. I'm sad about that. But I'm still celebrating you. You are a great group of young people. And Mr. C and I found a lot of solace, comfort, joy, fun times, and strength in being around you this year, which was a hard year for us. I want to thank you for being the kind, inclusive, loving people that you are. I know that you will do great things as you go off to high school, and I can't wait to hear all about it. Congratulations, grade 8s.